Hey and welcome back to my channel. Today I wanted to cover a topic that I find very interesting, one that on the surface might sound quite boring, but it may just be the highest chance that you have of becoming a millionaire. It's called cost averaging. Please remember to subscribe to the channel, and if you find any value in my content, smash the like button to spread the word. Before we get started, this video is not specific financial or investment advice tailored for you, and if you do require advice for your personal circumstances, you should speak to a financial advisor. And when investing in the stock market, it's important to remember that your capital is at risk, meaning the value of your investment could go up as well as down. So what is cost averaging? Cost averaging is also known as dollar cost averaging, or pound cost averaging, or rupee cost averaging. It really doesn't matter what the currency is, the concept's the same. In this video, I'm going to refer to it as cost averaging, as pound cost averaging just doesn't sound very good. It might be helpful to start with a definition of what cost averaging is. So according to investopedia.com, dollar cost averaging is an investment strategy in which investors divide up the total amount to be invested across periodic purchases of a target asset in an effort to reduce the impact and volatility of the overall purchase. The purchases occur regardless of the asset's price and at regular intervals. In fact, this strategy removes much of the detailed work of attempting to time the market in order to make purchases of equities at the best prices. Dollar cost averaging is also known as the constant dollar plan. So that's quite a mouthful, but to put that in simple terms, you're just investing money into the stock market on autopilot every single month without even thinking about it and worrying about the price of the stock that you're purchasing. And by doing this, you're removing the emotion of trying to buy at the right time, which people just aren't good at. It's a passive form of investing and an almost entirely hands-off approach, as you can just set up your payments to purchase your stocks monthly and go about your business for many years, and it just runs in the background. Cost averaging helps with two emotions that could ruin your financial future: fear and greed. This investment strategy stops you from piling money into the hot stock that you see in the news and prevents you from selling investments when the stock market crashes. And, oh, by the way, it will crash. Sometimes you'll be buying stocks at a premium when the stock market's up, and when the stock market crashes, when everyone's panicking and they're selling, you're buying. By doing this, you smooth out the bumps over time, providing consistent returns, which reduces volatility, which is essentially the up and down swings of the stock market. A good example of cost averaging would be a workplace pension. Every month before you're paid, a percentage of your pre-tax salary is deducted and added to your pension pot, hopefully with a good match from your employer. The reason this exists is to force people to save for their futures. If pensions had to be organized by everybody themselves, there would be a lot more people reaching retirement without any money in their bank, putting more pressure on the government to fund people's retirements. On a side note, the pension auto-enrollment scheme was introduced in 2012, where employees of companies in the UK were automatically enrolled into a company pension. And this is matched by an employer unless you opt out. This is a little bit like being tricked into receiving marketing when you don't tick box that says, "I don't want it." They're utilising the same psychological trick by making it easier to pay into your pension than not to. The motivation for this stems from lowering the burden of the government's money needing to spend on state pension in the future, and the hopes that people build up a decent nest egg in their own pensions. So it might be worth going back and checking if you don't have any of these pension pots from previous employers that you might want to consolidate into one pot so you have control over it. Lump sum investing versus cost averaging. So the question is then, is it better to invest a lump sum of money into the stock market or to drip feed it in using cost averaging? And the answer is quite simply to invest a lump sum. And this is shown in a 2012 Vanguard study where they produced a paper showing that over time, a lump sum does actually outperform cost averaging as you have more time in the market with your money. The problem I see with this though, and you might be screaming at your screen right now, is that not everybody is fortunate enough to have a lump sum of money ready to invest in the stock market. So cost averaging is actually the only practical way to invest over the long term for most people. Don't worry though, cost averaging still provides great results, and a great way to look at it is that it's the best way to invest in the stock market, unless, of course, you have a large windfall coming your way and a ton of money sitting in the bank ready to be invested in the stock market. And truthfully, even if you did have a lump sum of money there, are you going to have the nerve to invest it all into the stock market at once? Are you going to panic if as soon as you put it in, the stock market crashes? Or are you going to hold off putting it in because the market's too high and you're going to try and time the market? And this is where cost averaging helps. You feel less pain when the market crashes because you're buying stocks at a discounted rate. When the market rises, your portfolio amount goes up, so you don't mind buying stocks at a premium. So let's take a look at the 2012 Vanguard study, which I'll leave a link for in the description box below should you wish to take a look. Don't worry, it's only 8 pages, and it's pretty easy to digest. So Vanguard looked at 3 different countries, stock markets, and currencies. They looked at the UK, the United States, and Australia. So as you can see, they use different time frames across the market to get a good spread of time within the market. In this study, with the lump sum amount, they used a figure of £1 million or dollars or Australian dollars. When comparing to cost averaging, they used the same amount spread throughout a 10-year period and drip fed in the investments every 6 months. They used a range of asset allocations, meaning they used the same figures within a 100% stock portfolio, but then they also used other funds that have bonds in it too. If you want more information about this, check out the video linked above. So what they found is the lump sum investment actually outperforms cost averaging 2/3 of the time, meaning that around 60% of the time, on average, you're going to do better if you invest a lump sum versus cost averaging. For me though, the most interesting thing found in the study is that the difference isn't actually that much. Lump sum investing only outperformed cost averaging by 1.3% in Australia and 2.3% in the US. The paper concludes by stating that if the markets are heading upwards, then it makes sense to put as much money as you can into the market to use the compounding effect. However, they do state that cost averaging does have the benefit of removing the high emotions of putting large sums of money into the stock market. They also go on to make a very important point that past performance is not an indication of future returns. However, the market has always head upwards, and we can make an educated assumption that over time it's going to continue to do that. So, how do you get started with cost averaging? Well, you're going to need to choose an investment platform. I'm not going to walk you through that in this video, as I've already made a video about how to set up an account with Vanguard, which again, I'll link above. Personally, I would invest in index funds, which is basically a collection of stocks that mimic the stock market or a sector of the stock market. A good example of this is the S&P 500, which as you can see has performed pretty well over the years with an average return of 11 to 12% in the last 93 years. By investing in index funds, you're spreading your money across the market rather than investing into one company that may potentially go bust. Within an index fund, if one company goes bust, it's just replaced with another. Personally, I invest in the Vanguard Life Strategy 100 fund, which is 100% stock based. The important thing to remember though is to set up an automatic monthly payment to invest. This can be done with most platforms, and all you have to do is choose a date you want the payment to leave your account and decide what index funds you want to invest in. You will then get the benefits of long-term cost averaging, and it doesn't require extensive knowledge of investing or the stock market. You can put your feet up, get a cup of coffee, and don't let the media scaremongering force you into buying or selling at the right time. So to conclude, investing with a lump sum is better than cost averaging, but only by a small margin of no more than 2.3% over time. Genuinely, I think cost averaging is the best way for most people to invest, including me. It means that you can choose a monthly amount that you can afford to be invested within the stock market and let your money get to work for your future. If, however, you have a large sum of money and you want to invest, yes, putting that into the stock market should give you greater returns in the future. There's nothing to say you can't start with a lump sum and then continue to cost average over time. And truthfully, if I come into a lump sum of money, I'm going to invest it, but then I'm also going to continue cost averaging in the stock market. I personally invest 10% of my income every single month into index funds, and I don't even think about it. Thank you very much for getting this far and watching this video. As this channel is growing, I'm trying to find more topics that will add value to your financial life and help you make better decisions with your money. If you like this video, please remember to hit the like button and make sure you subscribe to my channel to get more content about personal finance in the future.